Hey, this is Cristi. Thanks for joining me. In this video, I'm going to show you a cool trick on how to create a stamping effect in Camtasia. This works in Camtasia 2020 and 2021. I'm doing it in 2021 now, but you can do it just as easily because we're using a feature that exists in both versions. So what I mean by stamping effect is one of those stamps that you can show like a fake stamp, just kind of approving a document or kind of appearing like a red grungy edge stamp that you stamp a document or you approve a video or something like that. And it's very easy to do. Let me show you. So I'm in Camtasia 2021 and I'm going to add a annotation. Go to annotations and just choose a text annotation and place it on your canvas. And let's double click and write the word approved like this. We want to make our stamp kind of say approved. You can say any text you like. I'm just going to make it a bit larger and I'm going to make the text a bit larger like this. And let's turn the text bold. I want a very bold text in here. You can, of course, use any font you want. So this is using no graphics coming from external sources. I don't have to, you know, so the text is perfectly editable. And I'll show you at the end how you can make it customizable in Camtasia 2021. And let's make this text red. Just use a very bright red in here. And I'm going to add a border for this. Now, in Camtasia 2021, and I believe also in 2020, if you go to Visual Effects, you can add a border. Unfortunately, the annotation like this doesn't have a border. So if you go here, you don't have a border. But we can apply this border visual effect to it, like so. And let's just make it very thick. And maybe more than 10, let's say 20 maybe. And let's make it red as well. So I'm just going to use the same red color. So far, so good. This is my stamp. Of course, I can click on it and resize this box so you can see, you know, it makes it any shape you like. And let's move on to the next part. The next part is making this look like a stamp. One thing that I want to do before I animate this is I want to make it look like a bit of grungy kind of thing where you know, it's showing a bit of texture maybe or something that it doesn't look so boring like this one. So the way we're going to do this is I'm saying, you know, we don't want to use any PNGs or exported files from other software. So the way to achieve this in Camtasia is by including a grungy bitmap with a grungy texture or something and then applying an effect to it on top of this video, on top of this text so that it makes it look you know, kind of random and grungy. So the way to do this is we go to the media bin here, and I just found this image on the internet. It's a texture, it's a grungy texture kind of graphic from the internet. Depending on how grungy you want to look, I found this on Pexels. You can go and download a lot of textures like this. Let me just make this large here. So you can see this grunginess here. It doesn't matter. We won't actually see this on the scene. So what I want to do is you notice that my stamp is at the bottom there. So it's now covered by this thing. So what I want to do is I want to apply a track mat. This is something was introduced in Camtasia 2020. A track mat applies a alpha or a luminosity effect to whatever is underneath the next track down. So on the track that I have this bitmap, I want to right click on this eye icon right here and choose the track matte mode for this track. And I'm going to use luminosity like this. There you go. You can now see that my stamp is looking very rusty, very sort of weird, grungy edges and all that stuff. So it looks more like a metallic kind of thing. You can actually do more with this, like you can change the opacity, but what I want to do is maybe change the contrast, because maybe if I'm not happy with the kind of grunginess, you can of course move the bitmap. You can see you can still move it. And, you know, when you're happy with the look, maybe you want it to be a bit finer, so you make the image smaller just as soon as it doesn't go out of the frame of your stamp. So you can go as small as this. So you notice here, I'm moving it here, so I kind of like how this works. And it looks like this. If you're still not happy with the way level of contrast, you can go to Visual Effects. I'm going to go to Visual Effects here, and you can drag a color adjustment on your bitmap, on the bitmap with the grungy texture that is now on the alpha with the track mat. I'm just going to drag this on top and watch what happens. This one adds a much more contrast. You can of course play with the controls on the right side to change the brightness of the effect or the contrast of the effect like this. Because you're adjusting that effect on that bitmap, that controls the luminosity. So there you have it. You know, when you're happy with your stamp, everything is cool. It looks kind of grungy now, you know, still moving it around here. Or maybe, you know, make it larger. It doesn't matter what you do. When you're happy with this, all you have to do is just select both of these things and group them. Control G to group them like that. Now, the reason they disappeared is because in Camtasia, when you group something, it brings everything together inside of the group. And inside of the group, there's all the track effects and everything you applied. So what we need to do now, on the remaining track, we want to right click and turn off the track mat. Put it to none, and there you have it. My object is done. Just to show you how to animate this now, because you want it to be sort of coming in at some point and you know, appear out of nowhere and stamp something, right? So for this purpose, I'm just going to pull in a video file with a skater dude. So at some point in here, I want to do, you know, show this jump and then apply this stamp on top. So I'm going to move this graphic here that I just created on top. So just click and drag it to the top. Okay. So this is the point where it needs to come in right here, right now. And there it comes in. Now, the way to bring this in is, of course, you want to animate it. So I'm going to zoom in my timeline here so I can see what's happening. So you can notice this guy just jumped in here, so my animation should come in from this point. Just move your group to the back. And the way to animate this is we're gonna make it very, very large, and let's zoom out a bit. Okay, like this. And I'm gonna make my stamp huge, something like this. And I'm gonna just rotate it a bit too, so it comes in kind of like that, starts there. I'm going to go just a few frames forward and just press go to animations. I'm going to go to animations, custom animation, drag the animation on this group here and maybe make it shorter like that, because I want my stamp to appear suddenly and with, you know, not much movement, just needs to appear from like very, very large, boom, just stamping my video. So if you notice here, I have not yet told it where to go. So I'm going to the end of the animation here. You see the final, the keyframe is highlighted, and zoom out a bit and just make this stamp small. Hold down the control key to resize proportionally and from all corners. And also I want to turn it sort of sideways like this a bit. So I'm just going to say approved here on the sky. Okay. So let's see what we did. I'm going to just go back to the playback. So let's see. You can see it just stamps it there. One other thing I want to do just before the animation runs, I want to go and turn the opacity down by going to this clip there and say opacity down like this. So now it appears and animates like that. Another thing you can do in Camtasia 2021, this new visual effect was added called motion blur. So actually you want to add, if you want to add a level of realism to this animation, you can go to visual effects and scroll down, and then you have motion blur here. So I deliberately put my playhead in between the two points, and when I add the motion blur effect to the group, watch what happens. My animation is now blurred, directional blur to where it's going, you know, radial kind of, I think it's radial blur where it goes down like this. So this blur effect, notice what's happening. I'm scrolling through my animation and it's making it sort of blurry because it gives it a bit of realism. So now that's my stamp right there. So you can play with this any way you like. You can do the animation kind of, if you're not happy with the final position, you can zoom in and maybe rotate it a little bit. And the thing that controls the motion blur intensity is the actual speed between the two keyframes. So the shorter the animation is and the larger, the longer distances it has to travel, the more pronounced the blur effect is. So if I move back in here and I make the animation much, much, much shorter, like a couple of frames, you notice the blur effect is so intense, you can hardly see anything on the screen. So I don't think you want that. You can play with it if you want, like this. So notice this is our animation with a stamping effect. And let me show you a cool trick with Camtasia 2021. This doesn't work in 2020. With Camtasia 2021, you can turn this into a reusable asset and add it to your library. And every time you want to apply a stamping effect with a different text like this or a different colors, you can use this trick, you know. So I'm happy with my approved animation here. Let's suppose I want to just leave it until here, till this point. So I'm just gonna just make it shorter like that, and just, you know, kind of maybe fade it out or something. I don't know. Let's just fade it out. Use a transition, zoom in a bit like that. So my stamp is going away in a few seconds. So watch this. This is my group with everything I need inside of it. So I have my text, I have my border, and I have my bitmap that creates that grungy effect, all with the alpha effect, with the luminosity effect applied to it and everything else. So this is a self-contained asset I can add to my library. Well, don't add it to your library yet, because if you come in here and you go to the right side here in Camtasia 2021, you have this text box here. Look, you can change the text that goes inside of the stamp. So if I want to say this something else, like rejected, like that, press enter, there you have it. I did not have to go inside of the group. I didn't have to double click on the annotation. The text just changes instantly because of this quick property. That's what it's called. It's quick property. You can even change the font and the color in here and all of that. Now you're ready to add this to your library. So I'm just going to right click and say add to library, and you add it to your library. Boom. You choose your library, and let's call it stamp, and use the canvas size for that. Press OK. So now Camtasia's added that to my library. So what I want to do is, you know, maybe later in a different project, I have another video. I'm just going to just drag another video in here with some playing card. Just turn off the sound and watch this. This is a video I just playing here. So now all I have to do is just go to my library, drag this stamp to where I want it to come in. You see it's coming in with the animation and everything, and it's playing like that. And of course you can click on it and you can change the text in here again, you know, travel or something, I don't know. So there you have it. We have created a reusable stamp animation that comes in out of nowhere. It looks grungy. You can control the grunginess. You can control, you know, make it look, and we did not have to use anything external except for that grungy bitmap that we imported that gives us this nice border effect. So I hope this was useful. Thank you for watching. And if you enjoy my tutorials, feel free to subscribe to my channel. And if you have any questions about this video or about any of the other tutorials or Camtasia, please feel free to leave it in the comments and I will respond and try and help you if I can. Thanks again for your time. See you next time.